Washed my sins away. presence of God, the Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on us right now. Spirit of the living God. Just as we were worshipping, I just sense a word for people here this morning, and thank you. You know, we're moving to a new place, and that's been a theme for so long. Lord, just drop something in my heart this morning. There are people who, in natural, normal, everyday life, you're about to move to a new place. I don't know if that's a new city or a new job or a new something, but there's something new. There's a new, in a crowd this big, there's bound to be people. That's how I'm not trying to claim something big here, but I do sense it in my spirit. You're moving to something, it's new for you. And let's just close our eyes. I just want to pray and prophesy for these people. If that's you, would you just raise your hand? You're ready to move to a new place and a new beginning. And, okay, so I really have Pete and Kath on my mind, I have to say. And I knew they were moving to a new place. But I was so prompted by the Spirit of God. And I believe God wants to say to you, He's not finished with you yet in the name of Jesus. He's not finished with you yet. And the plans that He has for you are not to harm you. They're to prosper you and to give you hope and a future. And in Jesus' name, the latter years can be greater than the former in the name of Jesus. And God wants to say to everybody moving to that new place, just the scripture that's on my mind, yesterday, today, forever, Jesus is the same. I don't know if this means specific for someone here this morning. The words are, the God who built the foundation yesterday, He can build the house today and He can build the house tomorrow. That for which He has prepared you all this time, He is the same God who can build on the foundation that He's laid in your life. Father God, I pray for all those facing something new. Courage in Jesus' name. Strength in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, that when they move and when they get to that place, You'll give them a sign that tells them You've gone before them, You're ahead of them, You're already there. And when the giants come, and when the trials come, and when the difficulties come, may they lift up their voice in praise and say, I am a child of the giant slayer in Jesus' name. Spirit of the living God, minister now grace to your people this morning. Minister grace. So strong on my spirit this morning with you. God has not finished with you yet. He hasn't. All the things that have gone on and all the path that you have trod, He wants you to know He hasn't finished you. There's more. There's more in Him for you. The Apostle John, when he was exiled on the Isle of Patmos, he'd seen it all. He'd been there. He'd seen blind eyes open. He'd seen the dead raised. As an old man in exile, in a place he would never escape from, he had the greatest encounter with Jesus of his life. I want to speak over your life this morning. Whatever you've been through, wherever you've been, however far, God wants you to know this morning, He still has plans for you right now, right here, and today and tomorrow. And they're good plans, and they're to prosper you. Take hold of His hand. Give your life to Him. Let's just lift our voices in worship, friends. Let's worship Him. But I'll stay near Him and stay.
Yeah.
can trust God. You can put your weight fully on Him. If God was a chair, you could sit fully on Him, take your feet off the ground, and know He will hold you. You can trust God. You can trust God with your future. You can trust God to take care of your past and the mess and all that stuff. You can trust God. You can trust Him this morning. You can trust Him with the rest of your life. And in difficulties and trials and good times and all those things, you can trust Him. You can fully, 100%, fully put your trust in the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. There is no other. There is no other way. There is nothing else in the whole of life and planet Earth in which you can so firmly put your trust and know that you know that you know it will bring you through. The arm of flesh will fail you, but the arm of the Lord will give you strength.
Amen.
So Lord, we give you praise.
Hallelujah.
We give you thanks.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for the presence of your Holy Spirit this morning. We give you all the honor and all the glory. And everybody said,
Amen.
Amen. Wow, God is good, isn't He?
All the
Why
time.
Why don't you wander about and hug as many people as you possibly can.